Tip got about 8 phones, man.
No, he don't.
Yeah, just the two. Same two?
Nah, man, to be honest with you, man, one of these Javon phones, he keep me posted on all of the goings on.
All the happenings.
And whatnot, yeah. Man.
So, you got a bit going on tonight, man. First of all, before we even get to the show, tell me about how did this relationship with Tidal come about?
Man, you know, to be honest with you, man, just without disclosing too much, man, I say that I've noticed that, you know, they're the main source of people who trying to put the power of what comes from music back into the hands of the people who actually influence the culture.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And I mean, you know, to me, that's probably one of the most important things for an artist to have equity in his art.
Right. So, I mean, when without disclosing too much, was it more of a, because you make great business deals. You have great business sense, you know, but, you know, many people have said that the record business is almost like any other business, even coming from the streets, that, you know, it's very, there, as T.I. said, very distinct similarities between the two entities.
This is true, but I mean, you know, it's supply and demand wherever you go. I think right now, man, it became so saturated.
Yeah.
You know, that you had to really, really be special to stand out. And I think that now it's bringing itself to a time where, you know, the cream is rising to the top, man. You know, and
nice.
I think all of the people who deserve to be celebrated are the ones who are being celebrated now.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Well, I heard the new song yesterday.
Oh.
I want to play it now.
Okay.
And then we're going to come back and talk about this what's going to happen tonight, how you going to shut it down.
Yeah.
So you want to introduce it to the city, man?
Yeah, absolutely, man. The first release, man, from the album Dime Trap, man. This year, Money Talk, man. You know, a lot of broke cats talk, they don't never get paid, man. You know what I'm saying? That's how it go.
B103.
Hey, long talk. You know, a lot of y'all like that, man, really, really like the one y'all mouth. Like, you just like to hear yourself talk, man. Talk so much, not knowing to empty the wagon, make the moon noise. Man. Get you some money, man.
Hey.
A lot of y'all talk, you don't never get pressed.
Yeah.
West side's on one bank here. Sucker gon' hate broke shit, throw shade. That's a shame, man. A lot of y'all talk, you don't never get paid. Get the gas, man. Still get shit, make a chick go crazy. A lot of y'all talk, you don't never get paid. Suck don't hate, bro, shit, no shot. Stick, flake, I'm a swag on turn up. Came with a zip, let the whole thing burn up. All I know, get dope, kid pimpin'. Time in that 85, never learned nothing different. Holla, see haters in my rear view. Me's in my windshield, got a clear view. I train myself, go deaf for a bro. That one when you talking, I don't hear you. Still poppin', get back, man. Talk, look at you, see you ain't about. Look at you, see you don't want to shit. Holla, be in the party when you sitting at the tip. It look inferior, don't it? Yeah. Give down what you don't know. I've achieved everything you can hope for. Being a real turn to a corporation. Look at me, shout out, I should be logo. See no photos as I'm stumbling that magic. At 4 was in a 2-door Bentley was heavy. She with the ashy, did she coming with me? But then now I leave her, she mean nothing to me. I pull her, hop, I get a valet, my keys. I run the city, parking for free. Man, who did right here talking to me? It gon' be problem, you keep bothering me, man. I came in it, this been 20s and 50 G. What you charge to park it, that ain't my business. Can't listen to me, now. God in my window, keep on in your earnings. I take every penny, I swear.
People station B103 tip in the building.
Like that.
Alright, you taking over something tonight, man. Go on and tell them what's happening.
Yeah, man. Well, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna take it back to the swatch and the Mall of Greenbrier was gracious enough. Was gracious enough to allow us to come out there, man, and turn up for the town. And you know, this was important to me because as I mentioned earlier, man, you know, this album is basically an extension of trap music. And trap music for me started at Greenbrier Mall, mm-hmm. not far from it, in Brier House Apartments on Camilton Road. So, I mean, it's very, you know, it's a special time to be able to take it back there and give it back to the people, you know, that contributed to the origin of this particular style of music.
Any pushback on this album creatively with people who say, man, Tip, you a movie star, you got a successful TV show, you know, maybe you should do something more mainstream.
I mean, I don't really listen to
stuff.
I didn't ask if you listened. I asked if did you get any suggestions of that?
Why do we want to, Clifford? Why do we want to do this right now?
Well, I mean, I urge people not to call me by my government name unless they have a check for me. So, if they, I mean, man, I don't know. I think everybody have a collection of opinions, man, and a lot of people have. I think it's, we have no shortage of opinions here over here at Grand Hustle. So, I think it may have been some like that. But I think after you hear the music speaks for itself. I think if you got music that justifies the subject matter.
Right.
If the song is jamming, then it's like, oh, okay.
Right.
Well, that's not that bad. Well, if you do it like that, then, you know what I'm saying? So I think, you know what I'm saying, we put a collection of songs together that justify the subject matter.
Yeah. Now, Wanda, you know, with the loaded backpack we give away this week, Tip is very familiar with the grand prize, which is an Xbox One.
Okay.
Now, we saw the video that you went into the store and just started buying gifts.
Man.
And I hit him up. I sent him a text.
Because
he was like, hey, man. Hey.
I know.
Ain't no more Xbox. Y'all know that, right?
I know. That was such a beautiful thing. And we're talking about over the holidays, you went into Walmart.
Yeah.
And, man, I mean, people was just in there shopping. You just kind of shut it down and start buying gifts for everybody.
Yeah.
I'm like, look at this, brother.
I just figured people needed some help, you know, to make their holidays come together, you know. It's always people at the last minute in there trying to get stuff, you know what I'm saying, that they didn't get a chance to get. And it's always something left off the list that you wish you could have got that, you know, it actually didn't come together for you.
But when you do things like that, it make you sleep well at night, don't it? Make you feel good.
I don't get much sleep, but you know what I'm saying, I do have...
You don't get much sleep?
I get, you know, I have moments of clarity.
Right.
Oh, clarity. Yeah, in the building right now. On the People Station, V103, home of the Ryan Kevin Warren Show with Wanda Smith. So how did this whole idea come about with going to the mall?
Hannah
Kane.
Yeah, that one.
Big Mama Kane. What up, Hannah?
Yeah, Hannah actually had the idea to go to the mall.
And so what you
I
like?
Mean, I mean, I didn't think, you know, if you can get them to do it, sure, right. You know? I mean, like I said, man, we always try and find things that's unique and that, you know, to speak to our core, but at the same time shows growth. Mm-hmm. And I think, you know, this was a fine moment where we were able to do both.
Yeah, because I think, you know, pulling this off, and it seems like you're right now doing things on your own time and as you see fit at this point in your career. You agree?
Yeah. Fortunately, you know what I mean?
That's a good thing, though.
That's a blessing, man. You know what I mean? I've been blessed to even be able to be here at album number 10 and still make a difference to people, you know what I'm saying? So it's a blessing to even be able to do what I love and earn a living for it.